Hello everyone, this is Varaprasad and I am presenting you the daily current affairs which are useful for SSC, RRB and other government examinations. Let us start the session with this one. Tata to buyout, take in JV Narishko Beverages. The size of the deal was not disclosed by the company. The move is an effort by Tata Group FIM to widen its portfolio in growing food and beverages space, TCPL said in a statement. Narishko, a 50-50 joint venture of TCPL and PepsiCo, operates in the healthy hydration space and has brands like Himalayan Mineral Water, Tata Gluco Plus and Tata Water Plus. This move is consistent with Tata Consumer's focus on widening its portfolio in the food and beverages space. These brands have been crafting their growth models, which are now ready for deployment on a wider scale, TCPL said in a statement. Narishko was formed in 2010 as a joint venture between Tata Global Beverages and PepsiCo India. Ircon International has signed an MOU with RZD International LLC to explore opportunities for joint development of railways and other infrastructure projects in Asia, Africa and Latin America. The announcement was made after market hours yesterday, 14th May 2020. Shares of Ircon International dropped 3.16% to close at 85.85 rupees on 14th May 2020. According to the MOU, both parties have agreed to form a joint Indian-Russian working group. This group will look into ways of developing strong partnership to coordinate a plan and subsequently implement projects in field of railways and other infrastructure, not only in India but also in the countries of mutual interest. RZD International LLC is a subsidiary of state-owned Russian Railways Company, which offers the whole spectrum of railway construction services and technologies, from pre-feasibility studies to execution and commissioning of turnkey projects abroad. Commenting on the MOU, MD of Ircon said this MOU will help the company to enhance its presence in different geographies. Government of West Bengal announces two schemes, Sneher Porosh and Prochesta. On 5th May, the Chief Minister of West Bengal, Mamata Banerjee, launched these two schemes to help the workers of unorganized sector of Bengal to enable them to earn their living in the lockdown situation. Prochesta scheme is to provide daily wages to the all daily wage workers whose livelihood are disturbed because of national lockdown. The scheme application submission commenced on 15th April 2020 and the last date for the submission of application is 15th May 2020. Sneher Porosh scheme is to provide support for migrant workers of West Bengal who are stranded in different parts of the nation. The scheme application submission commenced on 20th April 2020 and the last date for the submission of application is 3rd May 2020. Karnataka launches first accelerator for cyber security startup. Karnataka's Center of Excellence in Cyber Security launched the first cyber security accelerator for startups in India. HACK is an accelerator for cyber security in Karnataka. HACK, HACK, inaugurated on 16th May 2020 by Additional Chief Secretary in charge of Department of IT, BT and S&D, E.V. Ramana Reddy. HACK is an accelerator for cyber security in Karnataka. HACK, inviting all cyber security startups in both early stage and growth stage for applying for zeroth cohort launching in Q2 2020. HACK will provide an innovative incubation platform to connect startups with entrepreneurial ecosystems and marquee mentors around the world who are looking for a connection with government, industry and market players. The key objective is to promote a cyber safe and conducive environment for industrial collaboration, to address the skill gap, to build awareness and foster innovation in emerging technology field of cyber security. Acer India announced Back to School campaign. It is primarily aimed at helping students and their parents to easily procure a new Acer laptop and to ensure that learning never stops. In the newly launched scheme, Acer has partnered with EduThrill that uses gamification to deliver tests and assessment tools and unleashing more fun in learning and help students score better marks compared to traditional way of learning. Buying a new Acer laptop has never been this easier with zero down payment and EMI starting as low as 1666 rupees per month, along with peace of mind offer of 2 years additional warranty plus 1 year accidental damage protection absolutely free. And when the landing takes a break, customers can make use of Amazon Prime, G5 and Ghana subscription to kick back and enjoy some entertainment. Chandras Panigrahi, CMO and Consumers Business Head, Acer India, on this announcement said, "In this unprecedented situation, there are multiple opportunities explored with the right technology, particularly helping the students expand their potential to grow and succeed. We believe technology is changing the way millennials learn. With classrooms moving to the living rooms, the best investment any parent can make for their child is a laptop. So their learning never stops. Our offers are designed in a way which will help buying, owning, and enjoying the PC a great experience." Pearson India launches MyPedia Alexa skill to help enhance English vocabulary, listening, and comprehension. Today, Pearson India has introduced an interactive skill on Amazon Alexa for students and learners of all age groups to learn English. The Pearson MyPedia skill offers a collection of engaging stories coupled with fun facts, trivia, quizzes, and rewards. The interactive format of the skill can help in improving English vocabulary, listening, speaking, comprehension, and storytelling. To get started, say Alexa, open MyPedia, or simply Alexa, I want to learn English. The MyPedia skill is designed to enhance the interest of students in English language. The stories used in the skill can inspire them to be authors and be imaginative while writing in English. The skill's simple voice interface can enable students to learn in an interactive manner at their own pace. The MyPedia skill can be accessed on all Amazon Echo smart speakers, Echo Show smart displays, as well as Alexa app for smartphones. Thus, it will provide a holistic approach for students to build their language skills from home for greater goals outside academic achievements. In the current lockdown situation, as students spend more time at home, the MyPedia Alexa skill can help them make the most of this unique learning environment. According to Goldman Sachs, Indian economy to contract 5% in the financial year 21, which will be the deepest compared to all recessions India has ever experienced since 1979. It is against its earlier forecast of 0.4% contraction before revising it down to a level it shares with Japanese brokerage Nomura. The fiscal impact of the stimulus measures announced by government is very small at 1.3% of GDP. Slow growth will lead to more stimulus calls from the government, and the aid will be smaller compared to post-2008 crisis as well because of fiscal situation in India. The agency will continue to monitor its implementation to gauge its effect on the medium-term outlook for Indian economy. According to Bernstein, the US-based investment management firm has estimated the contraction of Indian economy at 7% during 2020-21. The forecast came even as the government announced a stimulus package spread over 5 days last week. While Bernstein, which has nearly $623 billion in assets under management globally, kept its projection unchanged after the stimulus. "The stimulus package of the government is a lost opportunity," said analysts at Bernstein. "The desire to show the world that they care about the economy and are willing to match global stimulus numbers was perhaps the driver behind the claim of the large package," Bernstein said. Kotak Mahindra Bank becomes the first bank in India to allow video KYC. The full form of KYC is Know Your Customer, facility for customers opening savings account on Kotak 811, the bank's digital banking platform. The initiative is presently being launched on a pilot basis for savings account Kotak Mahindra. With video KYC, verification of documents, signature are completed via video call with a representative from bank without any physical interface. In January 2020, the Reserve Bank of India amended the KYC norms and introduced the video-based KYC option to onboard customers. Kotak is the first bank to integrate the video KYC process in the account opening journey. Some of the static GK questions are: Kotak Mahindra Bank established in 2003. Kotak Mahindra Bank headquarters is in Mumbai, Maharashtra. Kotak Mahindra Bank Managing Director and Chief Executive Officer is Uday Kotak. Kotak Mahindra Bank tagline is Let's make money simple. Liberty Steel Group announced the appointment of Paramjit Kahlon as CEO, Primary Steel and Integrated Mining, Liberty Steel Group. This newly created role will bring together all of the Liberty's primary steel making and integrated mining operations into one global structure to drive synergies and operational efficiencies. Paramjit Kahlon is among the world's top global steel executives, having held senior positions at ArcelorMittal between 2008 to 2019, including as Chief Technical Officer, Chief Operating Officer, and more recently as CEO for CIS and Middle East. Liberty Steel Group is the 8th largest steel producer outside China with 18 million tons of steel products capacity. It employs 30,000 people across 10 countries and is organized into 3 divisions, Liberty Primary Steel and Integrated Mining, Liberty Green Steel and Liberty Steel Synergies. In April 2020, Liberty Steel Group announced the formation of Board of Directors, which includes executive and independent non-executive directors. Later this year, Liberty Steel Group will publish its first consolidated set of accounts for the year ending March 2020. Paramjit Kahlon's immediate focus will be on dealing with COVID-19 crisis and then ensuring the operations are sustainable over the long term through investment in low carbon technologies such as hydrogen, DRI and electric arc furnaces. HRD Ministry launched an AI-powered mock test mobile app for students set to appear for JEE Main and NEET 2020 examinations by National Testing Agency. While launching the mobile app National Test Abhyas, the HRD Minister Ramesh Pokhriyal Nishank said this timely launch is designed to ensure that no student is left behind in getting exposure to practice testing, especially when students lost due to closure of educational institutions is to be compensated and NTS test pack practice centers are shut due to COVID-19 lockdown. The HRD Minister said students across the country can use the app to access high-quality tests free of cost in a bid to be fully prepared for upcoming JEE, NEET and other competitive examinations. The NTA has also instituted live support from 10 a.m. to midnight for the first 7 days of release to ensure that any issues experienced by students are proactively addressed. The HRD Minister said, National Testing Agency plans to release one new mock test on the app every day, which students can then download and attempt offline. Once the test is completed, students can go online again to submit the test and view their test report. Japan's economy falls into recession for the first time since 2015. The world's third biggest economy shrank at an annual pace of 3.4% in the first 3 months of 2020. Last week, Germany slipped into recession as more major economies faced the impact of sustained lockdowns. The 3.4% fall in growth GDP for the first 3 months of 2020 follows a 6.4% decline during the last quarter of 2019, pushing Japan into a technical recession. Consumers in Japan have been hit by dual impact of coronavirus and a sales tax hike to 10% from 8% in October. While Japan has lifted the state of emergency in 39 out of its 47 prefectures, the economic outlook for this current quarter is equally gloomy. Analysts polled by Reuters expect the country's economy to shrink 22% during the April to June period, which would be the biggest decline on record. Every year, May 20 is celebrated as World Bee Day by United Nations. The official celebrations began in 2018. World Bee Day is celebrated to commemorate the birthday of Slovenian apiculture pioneer Anton Janša. This year, World Bee Day is celebrated under the theme Save the Bees. The day is being celebrated to raise awareness about the importance of pollinators, hummingbirds, butterflies, bats. The Convention on Biological Diversity focuses on conserving these pollinators as well. In 2000, the International Pollinator Initiative was launched at the COP Conference of Parties. The initiative focuses on the sustainability of pollinators in agriculture. Bees are greatest pollinators. They are under great threats currently due to habitat loss, parasites, diseases, and agriculture pesticides. According to United Nations, around 35% of world agriculture still depend on pollinators. South Central Railway Zone has developed a robotic device, RailBot, RBot, to assist in hospital management functions toward patient care in the wake of COVID-19 outbreak. The innovation developed by Hem Singh Banoth, Additional Divisional Railway Manager, has come in for praise from the zone's head, Gajan Malia. The RBot underwent extensive trial and demonstration before being deployed for use in Central Railway Hospital, Lalgunda, Secunderabad. RBot is being used to provide medicines, medical accessories, and to serve food to patients without any need for physical contact. This will enable doctors, nurses, and other support medical staff to stay away from risk of contracting infections. The RBot is operated through a unique mobile application developed as part of innovation, supported by Wi-Fi facility. The RBot holds sensor-based features to read the body temperature of patients and transmit the same for display on mobile phones. It is capable of raising an alarm in case of any abnormally high temperature readings so as to alert the medics attending to patients. The last one of the session is Disney's head of streaming to become CEO of TikTok. He has been named the Chief Executive Officer of TikTok and Chief Operating Officer of ByteDance, the platform's Chinese parent company. TikTok, an app where users post short videos, has seen an explosion of growth since its US launch, but that increased popularity has led to scrutiny by US government over its tie to China. Mr. Mayer will be responsible for ByteDance's global development, including emerging business, gaming, and music. I am excited to help lead the next phase of ByteDance journey as the company continues to expand its breadth of products across the every region of the world, Mr. Mayer said in the release. We are providing you the PDF of this entire session in the description box below. People who want to download the PDF can go to the description box and click on that link so that you can download the PDF. Thank you everyone. Please subscribe to our channel for more updates. Please give your valuable suggestions in the comment box.